πολλές φορές δεν μου μιλούσε, δεν έλεγε ούτε καλημέρα. Ήταν πάντοτε πολύ συγκρατημένο. Και έπρεπε εγώ να του μιλήσω, να του πω καλημέρα για να μου απαντήσει και εκείνος. Φυσικά το μετά σιγά
as kids, we loved listening to these stories. Little did we know then that one such tale was about to unfold in our midst.
Lost in the Bewilderness, it is a special film for many reasons. One of those reasons is that you spent 30 years on it. Did you plan on spending 30 years on that project?
You know, most documentaries, you don't know how long they're going to take, especially ones that are about real life, like this one is.
This is your aunt, Katina.
Aunt Katina.
If I like you,
she can't see very well, but...
If you're filming someone's life, there's no end, you know. That was one of the things where I didn't know where it was going to end. The challenge was to put a dramatic arc on a real story, because real life is not that neat. But the longer it took, I realized that that was one thing I became very interested in, which was the passage of time.
Everyday notes.
So all these and all these are for this one.
Something that, you know, you rarely have the luxury to do if you're working for television or even for film. So it was a privilege, but it was also really tough because I felt like it was never going to be done. And I can't believe it's actually finished. You know, it's been half my life that I've been working on it.
Lost in the Bewilderness is actually about your cousin, that you said, your family. What is it like having to produce a film, do all of this with something that is so close to you?
You know, I feel really protective of everyone, and I feel like, you know, I take things personally. If somebody doesn't like the film, it really feels, I feel much more raw in a sense, because it is about my family.
What has your relationship been like with your cousin since you started working on Lost in the Bewilderness?
Well, it was really hard at first because he was almost 16. He was a stranger in a strange land when we found him. And here I was with this big camera in his face, and he was so uncomfortable. And he would have been uncomfortable anyway, but I felt like I was one more element that wasn't helping.
What could the fates have had in mind to make my cousin Lucas disappear? To understand, we have to go back, all the way to the beginning, where all myths come from.
I always hoped that he would, when he was older, that he would appreciate that there was some record of this time, and that I helped to fill in the blanks, because he didn't remember, didn't know about a lot of these things that are in the film. But I was so nervous to show it to him. He saw it. And it was amazing. He couldn't believe what a jerk he was when he first arrives, because everyone's trying so hard to, you know, just make him feel at home. And he's just like this, like, catatonic, monosyllabic teenager.
Technology, filming technique, things change. How were you able to adapt during those changes throughout 30 years?
The film actually shows the whole span, because the first footage that I shot was Super 8, which some viewers may never have even heard of Super 8.
Hello.
The bulk of the film was filmed in 16 millimeter. And then only recently, in the last 10 years, I did some standard def, and then the very end went to high def. But I was actually editing on a Steenbeck, and a Steenbeck is a flatbed where the film goes through one gate and the sound goes through another, and you cut it with a guillotine splicer and you splice it together. And so I worked that way up until, 2 years before I finished the film. And then I transferred everything to digital medium so I could actually finish it in a sane way.
Editing and producing and sound recording, narrating, you did it all. Why did you choose to do it all?
I can't imagine not doing it all. I was a student at MIT at their film section, which at that time really encouraged people to, shoot your own films and edit your own films and be your own crew, either one person or two people, and keep it really simple. It was sort of the birth of cinema verite coming into its own, which was filming real life without lights, without making people say things over again, without a big crew. I mean, it really behooved the subject matter to have as few people as possible when you're in people's homes, in their lives, hanging out with them for, months, years. So, and this film is about my family. So it's just me. I mean, I love to shoot, I love to edit, I love to write. So it just felt like I can't imagine anybody else doing any of it.
You're a teacher. What's something that you hope students they leave with after they take your course and work with you?
I would say to just not be afraid to take a risk and find confidence in what is important to them, what's true to them, and not to be trying to make a film that they think is going to be cool or sexy or somebody else's or a calling card, but to be as honest as they can be.